Car shooting right away. Is that going?
What the fuck?
Look at it, look like a UFO and shit. What the fuck?
It's gonna be getting chased by a UFO in a minute.
Shit, we gonna be chasing it.
Yeah.
We gonna fly. We gonna fly up there, grab it by the tail, just swing that motherfucker.
Right, right.
Like the Incredible Hulk type shit. We just gonna jump up and punch it.
Oh damn, you see that shit on the bottom of it? It looked like it had like some kind of X-ray machine on the bottom of
it. They do got it, because they can see through your houses in pure color, in 3D. They came out with it in the news. Alex Jones was talking about that shit.
Yeah, see exactly where you are and everything. Through your conversations.
They said they can see through your walls, going through your Wi-Fi. Plus everybody's TVs, all them brand new TVs, everybody got the big screen TVs.
Oh yeah, they said they just spied, hacked Kim Kardashian's webcam or some shit.
That's all they care about is that bitch's ass. It's fake. It is fake.
No, it wasn't Kardashian, it was the dude who just had the sex change, her dad or something.
I don't know.
It was all over the news a couple weeks ago, you remember his name?
You talking about the Manning dude? That dude's in prison. Manning?
No, the dude who just ran somebody over and killed him, Jennings or...
Oh yeah, I heard about that, I forget the name. Fucking weirdos. Yeah, that's why they wanted to get the Xbox Kinect in everybody's house. Because that Xbox Kinect is spying on your ass.
Oh, Samsung tells you in their guides that they can listen in on your conversations.
And they send the because they claim that they listen to your conversations. So they'll take what you're talking about and sell it to advertisers and to sell advertisements to you like Google does. Like every time you type something into Google search engine, it puts it into a database. And they base what advertisements you see on what you search for. You know what I'm saying? So if you're always searching for Israelite shit, they're going to advertise Bible stuff to you. You know what I'm saying? If you're always searching for computer stuff, they're going to advertise computers.
Plus, you can have a conversation and then pick up your conversations too.
Yep. Specifically, when I looked this camera up online, it was showing up on the side of Facebook for weeks straight.
That's crazy.
They already knew you was looking for it.
Yep. Same with the coat. I'm wearing fucking boots.
That's Esau, man. Esau got to know everything you're doing. He got to know everything you're doing. He trying to be like the Most High.
I don't use Google. Actually, I do use Google.
I don't use it either.
Because it works. It works pretty good. You know what I'm saying?
But I never liked it.
You know?
I never liked nothing
but
about
usually
it.
But usually, I use a Start Page.
Okay.
And DuckDuckGo.
Yeah, I ain't never used
it.
I don't like it.
What do you use? Y'all know?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I mean, I use... It depends, because sometimes, if I'm doing research... I use DuckDuckGo and Start Page. But sometimes, god damn it, you put that shit in Google, that shit will come right up. Motherfuckers, man.
Google's something else, man. You should see the profits they make.
Yeah. What's amazing is that we uploading all this shit right here to Google servers. You know what I'm saying? All these videos, we done uploaded billions upon billions of gigabytes to Google servers. I don't even understand how that's even possible. So they gotta be making some big money. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Fuck.
You got a Bible app? You got Isaiah 60 already? Let's just read it from the top.
60 will come back.
Yeah, I was
the kingdom.
Yeah, I was just, you know what I'm saying? They was talking about the kingdom.
Yeah, 60 is a bad track. All of Isaiah hot, man. Yeah, you can't find nothing born in Isaiah.
That's why sometimes we come out here, we don't know what to read, because there's so much fire in the Bible. But that's a good point, though. It's like people ain't got no excuse for not teaching or to not have a topic to talk about. All you gotta do is open the book to a random spot and start reading.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's
too hot.
There's gonna be some fire.
Ain't nothing born about this book.
If you out there teaching and you don't know what to talk about, just open it up and start reading from anywhere.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It don't even matter. All right, go ahead with that.
Well, people that don't come out and teach, they don't want to teach anyway.
Yeah, that's something I learned, though, man. Yeah, because some people, they might be nervous. You know what I mean? Yeah. Don't be nervous.
Yeah, you can understand that. Understand
that. I was nervous the first time I went teaching. It's like busting your first nut, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's a disgusting analogy, but It's kind of what it is, though.
Right.
But it really is like, you know what I'm saying? It's like what they call popping your cherry.
Oh, yeah.
Losing your virginity.
Oh, yeah. Once you get over that hump, man, it's right. smooth selling. It's smooth selling, man.
The first time I was, you know what I'm saying?
Let me read this real quick before you get to Isaiah 4. I'm going to read Isaiah 34:16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail. None shall want her mate, for my mouth it had commanded.
Yeah, so you ain't supposed to be out here coming out of any other book. If you call yourself a spiritual person, because you got these fools on YouTube talking about ancient Egypt had all the mysteries and the truth. And I was just thinking today, I was watching some of those Egyptologist fools on YouTube. Now it got me to thinking. I was like black people in America, they didn't start saying they was Egyptians till recently. That's like a new thing, ain't it?
Yeah, that's new. That started like late 60s.
Yeah, all of a sudden out of nowhere, motherfuckers all of a sudden Egyptian.
Mm-hmm.
All of a sudden.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here it is. When y'all was in slavery, y'all wasn't praying for the Pharaoh to come and save you. Y'all was saying, sweet chariot, come to carry me home.
Damn right.
And then you said for the chariot to take you home by the River Jordan. You know what I'm saying? So you people don't make no sense talking that Egypt shit, man.
Don't make no motherfucking sense.
That's a new thing that just started recently.
And then it died out for a while.
Yeah, it died
came
out.
Came back again
came
in
back.
The 80s. Died out again.
So, yeah, all of a sudden, out of nowhere, motherfuckers are from Egypt.
Right. You gotta be out of your motherfucking mind.
But you got fools always talking about some goddamn pyramids and talking about the Book of the Dead and all this other bullshit. Then you got people talking about the ancient Babylonians and the Anunnaki and ancient aliens and shit. People's bugged out, man. You about to read something else?
Nah, go ahead.
Bust out that Isaiah 60. Yeah, just start at the top, because there's a lot of meat.
Isaiah 60, verse 1. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people.
Yeah, so the people are in gross darkness. So we got all kind of people on YouTube. They actually going out their ways to make videos saying that Jesus is actually Zeus, and the Lord is actually Osiris, and the God is an alien, the angels are aliens, and the Anunnaki. You know what I'm saying? People are bugged out. They're saying that the angels are reptilians. They're watching David Icke. People was bugged out, man. Keep going. That's some gross darkness. And then you got a lot of our people, they call themselves atheists and agnostics. They don't believe in nothing. They just totally lost. Go ahead.
The Lord shall rise upon them, and his glory shall be seen upon them. And the Gentiles shall come in thy light, and the king to the brightness of thy rising.
Right, because Israel scattered among all nations. Keep going.
Lift up thine eyes round about and see all they gather themselves together. They come to see thee. Thy son shall come from far, and thy daughters shall be nursed by thy side. Then shall thy seed and flow together, and thine heart shall fear and be enlarged, because the abundance and the sea shall be converted unto thee. The forces of the Gentiles shall come unto thee. The multitude of camels shall cover thee. Dromedaries, Medan and Abra.
Dromedaries? Is that how you say it? Who's it?
Six. Where you at? Six. Can't see no little ass letters.
Where you at? What verse you in?
Yeah, six. Yeah.
Six?
Yeah.
Yeah, you way down there already?
Yeah, the drama. Yeah, we had to look that up.
Dromedaries, yeah.
Yeah, drama. That's a messed up word, ain't it?
Are they from Shex?
I think it was me and you who was looking that up one day.
Yeah, we looked it up.
Yeah.
I gotta look it up again.
Are they from Sheba shall say, they shall bring gold and incense, and they shall show forth the praises of the Lord. And the flocks of Kedar shall be gathered together unto thee. The rams of Nabaioth.
That's all right. This is, I mean, you can't say a word. Just keep going.
Yeah, Nabaioth.
Yeah, some of the words is tough.
Yeah, tongue twister.
Shall minister unto thee. They shall come up with abundance appearance on mine altar, and I will glory the house of my glory. Who are these that fly as a cloud and as the doves to the windows?
UFOs.
All right, well, that's your boy. Remember years ago that dude came out trying to quote that scripture?
Yeah.
Talking about the doves in the windows. I forget what he was talking about. Because he kept trying to prove to us that Jesus loves everybody. He's like, he loves everybody. He came to the window like a dove or something. He was bugged out, man. Every time I read that scripture, it makes me think of that dude, man. That was like 5 years ago. Yeah, because Israel scattered among all nations. So when the Lord comes back, the Lord's going to gather Israel from all these nations, you know what I'm saying? So we're going to put it back in our rightful land. The whole earth is our land, actually. Keep going. But Israel is the HQ.
Verse 9. Surely the ISILs shall wait for me. And the ships of Tarshish.
Tarshish. You know where that's at? Where's Tarshish?
Spain.
That's Spain. Yeah, you'll see that a lot, because you'll see the, because the original name of Spain is what? They call it Tarshish in the Hebrew, but then they also call it Iberia. And where does the word Iberia come from? Hebrew. Because Spain back in the ancient world was called Iberia. That's because you had a large colonies of Israelites living up in Spain. Yep. Oh, but go ahead. Yeah, because Israel is all through the Mediterranean. The Mediterranean Sea, that was pretty much Israel's playground, man. Oh, go ahead.
To bring thy sons from far, the silver and their gold with them. Unto the name of the Lord thy God, and to the Holy One of Israel, because he hath gloried them in thee. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls.
Oh, look, that's a good point. He said, the sons of the strangers shall build up our walls. Come on, the walls to the city. They're going to build up our buildings. Because in the kingdom, we're going to have to build everything from scratch. You know what I'm saying?
Everything.
Because right now, the land, the actual land of Israel has been polluted, it's been defiled. They got heathens and devils living over there, polluting the land. So that land has to be purified with fire. So in the kingdom, we got to build everything. Everything's going to be new. And so we're going to use the heathens, these other nations. They're going to be our servants, and they're going to build up the kingdom for the actual work while we laying back. You know what I'm saying? Just chilling. Cracking with whip. It's like that.
Hell yeah, hitting them with that scepter. Knocking them upside the head with our scepter.
Well, Esau, we're going to really give it to Esau.
He's going, ooh.
But the other heathens, the regular heathens, they're going to be happy we rule it. Because they're going to be happy Esau's in slavery.
Right.
If somebody was, these boys, Shaman Trainer, he used to be a troll, but now he would like our videos. He made a comment on the comment board. He said, I'm going to have somebody come up. He said he's going to have Esau bring him a glass of wine and come over and bow to his feet. When he comes down with it, he's going to kick it out of his hand and tell him to pick it up. When he goes to pick it up, he's going to kick him in his ass. And that's how we're going to do it, man.
Yeah, we're going to be vicious, man. Vicious.
Yeah, we're going to be vicious. Oh, God, keep going. That was a good one.
Oh, shit. I had a few seconds. Go ahead, though.
Verse 10, and the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, and their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor have I have mercy on thee.
Right, because the Lord was angry at us, right? Because we didn't keep his commandments. Because we blasphemed the Lord, you know what I'm saying? We wanted to follow the ways of the heathen. So the Lord fucked us up. But in the kingdom, you know what I'm saying, he's going to reward us. Keep going.
Therefore, thy gates shall be open continually. They shall not be shut day or nor night. Men may bring into thee the portions of the Gentiles, and that their kings may be brought.
Right, the portions of all the riches and all the wealth and substance the other heathens and nations got, it all belongs to us. You know what I'm saying?
You see, over in Israel last week, they found in the shipwreck with all this gold coins.
All the gold coins.
You see that? Yeah. Israel know where all that shit is because they study this book, man. and whatever books they got hidden up in the Vatican or whatever libraries they
have. All the ancient history books. Mm-hmm.
They got all that shit. They got it all. That's how they knew that shit.
Because they got accounts of shipwrecks probably written down, mm-hmm. but now they got the technology. You know what I'm saying? They got submarines and they got different boats with cranes, and they can actually go to the, you know, say to the bottom of the ocean and get that shit.
Hell yeah.
Because now they can breathe underwater now.
They're getting down. You know what I'm saying? They're getting down. Let me read this. This is Psalms 149 and 6. Let the high praise of the Most High be in their mouth, and a two-edged sword in their hand, to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishment upon the people, to bind their kings in chains and their nobles with fetters of iron.
Right, because you don't kill the kings, all these different rulers of these different nations. We ain't going to kill them. We're going to put them in slavery. Mm-hmm. And you don't kill kings, you put them in slavery. That's just too easy of a punishment.
That's a bigger punishment, locking them up.
Like the Rothschilds. You know, you got all these famous French Edomite families like the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, the Clintons, the Bushes. Who's some of these other devils? All these so-called Jews, these prominent rabbis and all these other faggots. Mm-hmm. We ain't going to kill them. They're going to go into slavery.
Ain't right. That's the worst thing that can happen to them. Death, you're right. Death is too easy. Death way too easy. They don't deserve no rest. That's a rest getting put to death.
It is a rest.
You know? Shit. To execute upon them the judgment written, this honor hath all his saints. Praise ye the Lord.
Yeah, so that's an honor. And we're the saints, you know what I'm saying?
Damn right.
So yeah, we're going to have a two-edged sword in our hand. What do you do with a two-edged sword? Go ahead, bring that out. Go back to the Isaiah
60 and 12. For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee shall perish. Yea, those nations shall be utterly wasted.
So that's damn near every nation on earth. Especially numero uno is America. Okay, because America, they ain't served the Most High. Not even the least. I see something that pissed me off today. They just decriminalized adultery in South Korea. You see that?
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah, yeah.
Before it was a crime.
Yeah.
And then they said condom sells a sword.
Yep.
What the fuck, man? So that's just more American influence on the rest of the world. The South Korea was already Americanized since the Korean War. So this whole world has been polluted, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's crazy, man. You know that's America there for sure. South Korea.
Yeah.
That's crazy, man. This is Daniel 11 and 18, 7 and 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, ever, forever, and ever.
Forever and ever and ever. So that's cool. That's cool. Forever's a long time.
So that's going to be a lot of building.
Shit. Oh, yeah, we're going to... Yeah, you thought...
That's going to be a lot, man.
You thought what they built in the ancient world was magnificent.
Mm-hmm.
What they building now ain't shit. These raggedy-ass buildings got no art, no style to it. I was just watching what was I watching, man? I was watching a James Bond movie. Yeah, I just caught a few minutes of it. But they was up in the Hagia Sophia, you know, up in Constantinople. What was that James Bond movie, Sean Connery? They was up in Istanbul, Constantinople. But anyway, I was looking at that architecture, that Byzantine architecture. That shit was magnificent. The big-ass temples, they got gigantic pillars. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
This shit is amazing.
How long did it take to build Solomon's crib?
Shit.
14 like, years?
Yeah, it took years.
Like 14
years?
And
years.
And the temple took a little less than that, I think.
Yeah, his house took longer to build than the temple.
The temple took a little less, but hey, the temple was
your
magnificent.
Homie.
The temple was magnificent.
Sure was.
All of it was. So, you know, we got wild-ass imaginations on how our crib is going to look. You know, we can go buck wild, make a video on that alone, talking about the benefits of the kingdom of heaven. Just the benefits alone, put the spirit up in you.
Hell yeah, I'm gonna have shit.
I'm gonna have a waterfall going to my crib.
Oh yeah, well, I was about to say, I'm gonna have, I'm gonna have tree houses. Yeah, waterfalls.
A natural waterfall.
Inside of it.
House going right through it. You know
that's
what I'm
badass
saying?
Shit.
Hell yeah,
it's,
man.
This is gonna be better than Mr. Miyagi's crib.
Mr. Miyagi.
Remember his shit?
Yeah.
His boy had the Japanese garden. Yeah, fish and shit.
I'm gonna have a garage for my dragon.
Hell yeah. It's gonna be nice, man. Whatever your wild imagination, man. A wild imagination. Shit. Esau ain't got shit. He thinks he got something, though.
I
you think he can get in his airplanes and go to the other side of the world day after day after day? Man, we're going to be going to planets after planets.
Hell yeah.
You know, Esau ain't got shit on what we're going to have.
Hey, they
nah,
wish
spiritual motherfucker.
They wish he can go to other planets.
Mm-hmm. You know I be looking at them photos and shit they be taking to the planets, man, and they talk about their satellites. There ain't no satellites out there. You can see it's an Earth or the satellite that's circling the Earth taking those pictures of those planets, man. You can see ain't no satellite up close to those planets.
Hell no.
It looks like a photo from a distance.
I'll tell you, that Mars footage is fake.
Hell yeah. You know that.
I tell you,
you know that.
They shooting that down at the right. Atacama Desert down in South America.
Mm-hmm. And airbrushing the photos or changing
that
the
shit,
color.
That shit look, all, it, look all digital, man.
Yeah, it looks stupid. It's stupid. Goddamn dumbass
devils. You got something else you gonna bring out?
Nah, keep rolling with it.
I was going
with
the rest of
it.
Isaiah.
Yeah, keep rolling with it.
Yeah, there's some juicy parts in there.
I don't know.
Isaiah 60:13, the glory of Levian shall come unto thee. The fire, the fig tree, the pine tree, and the box together to beautify the place of my sanctuary.
Oh, shit.
All right. Bible falling apart.
To beautify the place of my sanctuary, and I'll make the place of my feet glorious. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come binding and bending unto thee, and all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet.
That's our way Esau, yeah, because Esau afflicted our people, put us into slavery. But we in slavery right now. If you say you're not a slaver now, you're stupid, man. You're simple as hell. This shit right here is torture living out here. This shit. Hey, we gotta get, man.
The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto them to thee.
So this proves we gonna have slaves. All these Edomites, they all going into slavery, man. All them so-called Jews, they done stole your heritage, stole your identity, they going straight into slavery. All the so-called the elite. People called the Illuminati, they all going into slavery.
Damn right.
Yeah, man, that's a wild spirit over there.
That's Satan over there. That's a damn devil over there.
That's all right.
That's a black devil. That's a black devil.
He's just doing his job.
Yep, being a
you
devil.
Know what I'm saying?
Being a goddamn devil. I feel like we're broken his ass.
I mean, we got power over all demons and spirits. You know what I'm saying? The Lord, he tell you that all the demons, they listen to the name of Yahushua. And he's just possessed by a demon.
Mm-hmm.
It's not him that talking. That's that demon talking. That's the foul spirits, man.
Yep.
Get your dude Bob Larson out here.
Oh, you're going to put Bob Larson. You're going to do an exorcism.
Oh, man.
How many generations?
What's your name? Come out of him.
You watch Bob? Don't watch Bob Marshall.
No. No.
I watch that shit when I get drunk. I want to laugh.
Oh, Marshall.
I ain't watched that dude in like a year. With different men, we was watching Bob Larson every day just to get a laugh. That shit was better than Dave Chappelle.
He selling crucifixes for like $80.
He got special crucifixes.
Yeah, it's been a while since we watched that motherfucker.
They're the fucking con artists, man. The people eat that shit up, though, man.
Oh, you can pay him to do a live video or exorcist.
Oh, yeah, you can pay. Yeah, you gotta pay him to do an exorcist. Where in the scripture does it say?
But he do it over the internet through a video. Like, yeah. Oh, that's really gonna work.
Yeah, but as long as you got that PayPal account, he can exorcise them demons. I mean, the people are so simple, they fall for that shit, man.
Simple as money. Simple people.
It's simple, believe in every word. You know what I'm saying? It's not like goddamn pork out here, don't it? Don't it?
It always stinks out here.
It's going like straight up swine.
Damn, we done drifted down like 20 feet
we
already.
We always do that. We out here hobbling, we be drifting and drifting. Man, Esau is going into slavery. They shouldn't even be allowed to even cook pork in none of these restaurants. That should be illegal.
Damn right.
That's all they serve.
Oh, you know how they get the, they got the, you go to a restaurant, they got like an A grade or whatever from the Department of Health. If they serve pork, they should get a goddamn F.
Well, shut down.
Shut down. It's a health violation. All right, go ahead with that scripture. Whatever. Read that one again. Oh, you got a precept you want to bring out first?
No, go ahead.
Okay, well, I want to hear that one again.
I want to hear it again, too. Yeah.
Okay.
Isaiah 60.
It just got a nice sound, too.
Isaiah 16, verse 14. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall come bending unto thee. And all they that despise thee shall bow themselves down at thy soles of thy feet. They shall call thee the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel.
Right. Mm-hmm. So yeah, all these motherfuckers out here is controlling us, all these politicians, you know what I'm saying, the royal families, they all going into slavery, man. John Kerry, that fucking creepy ass cracker, straight into slavery. I don't know why he just pops in my head. He just
Obama and his mama.
Oh yeah. Oh, they go back to the ancient Egyptians too. The ancient Egyptians had Israel in slavery.
Yeah, right.
So if you people out there claiming that you're Egyptian, if you're really an Egyptian, I guess it's slavery for you.
Right. Let me go back to that one.
That says the same thing as Revelation 2. Revelation 2 said we're going to rule all nations with a rod of iron. Is that 2 and 26? You keep reading until he get that.
That's Satan for real.
Oh, what you got? What you about to bring out?
Oh, just us crying in the penal.
Okay.
I think this is it. This is Exodus 2. And 23, and it came to pass in the process of time that the king of Egypt died, and the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. And they cried, and their cry came up unto the Most High by reason of their bondage.
Yeah, they was crying out to the Most High.
Yep. And the Most High, Yahweh, heard their groaning, and the Most High remembered his covenant with Abraham and Isaac and with Jacob. And the Most High looked upon the children of Israel, and the Most High had respect unto them.
So that's why we out here crying. We out here crying and pleading right now, you know what I'm saying?
This is a sincere cry, too.
Right, because the Most High hears your prayers,
yeah,
right?
It's a sincere cry. Because this is hardcore bondage we in, man. Hardcore taxes we serve, you know?
Well, in the Bible, it says you're only supposed to pay 10% of your earnings or whatever.
Yeah.
In America... Right. They take like 30-40% of your
sometimes
check.
Sometimes 50.
Sometimes, oh, yep. Don't.
Or you make.
If you make, say you got a good job, too bad for you. They taking half your check.
Right.
Over there in France, they taking more than half.
Hell yeah. I watched this show called Gold Rush, man. And this young kid, man, his family always had money because they was digging that gold up off the ground. This motherfucker's ain't number like 19, 20 years old. And he's in control of a multi-million dollar operation digging gold out the ground.
Mining gold?
Yeah, and this motherfucker, in like 3 months, he dug like over $2 million
Damn.
Worth of gold.
He must be good at this.
Yeah, and yeah, he's bad, man. And once he got to a certain point, there's like your royalties goes up to 20%. You know what I mean? They started digging more in his pocket, man. This motherfucker's walking away from the camera talking shit.
I just looking at reading the news today. They say they getting Robert De Niro. The IRS is getting Robert De Niro for like
$6 million. Damn.
We get a bunch of goddamn devils, man.
That's proof that motherfucker's an Israelite.
Proof he's an Israelite.
That's proof.
Because what happens, they do it. You thought they was so successful and rich.
Mm-hmm.
But when you get to a certain age and they can't use you as much no more, then they start dicking you.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So they robbed Robert De Niro, taking all his money. They took all Wesley Snipes' money.
Locked his ass up.
Lauryn Hill took all her money. You know what I'm saying? Who else?
Willie Nelson?
Willie. They got Willie Nelson's ass. Willie Nelson hate the goddamn IRS.
Right.
Willie Nelson hate the government, period. That's why he be doing the Farm Aid concerts.
I know Ja Rule's a demon, but he was all talking about the Bible and shit, but where's Ja Rule? Where is he at now?
Shit, that faggot. He was locked up for a minute, came out a bigger faggot. Yeah, he was locked up for a while.
What's that one song?
He just got out last year. Came out making some Christian movie with this black bitch.
Did he?
Hell yeah.
Oh, man.
Some nigga shit. A woman's movie. That's
I remember that one song. Can we get a break? We ain't really happy here.
I ain't never liked that.
You don't remember that shit?
Yeah, I remember it, though. I remember that shit. Yeah, Sammy Davis Jr., Red Fox.
Sammy Davis Jr., he deserved what he got. He was member of the Church of Satan.
That's where they scared this ass at.
Yeah.
They scared the shit out of him.
That black demon.
If y'all seen the movie with Mark Wahlberg when he was a porn star.
Oh, shit.
I don't want to.
It was a movie. Y'all never seen that?
I seen that shit, yeah.
Party where some shit went on at that party. Sammy Davis Jr. was in that at that party.
Oh, for real?
Where a murder took place.
Oh, yeah, I remember that, yeah.
They didn't put him in the movie, though, but he was at that party. Because that movie is actually based around some real-life shit.
That's a fucking weirdo movie, man.
I'm not sure if it was John Holmes.
It was John Holmes.
Yeah. Hell yeah, that's a really actually based on a real life movie, man.
Yeah, that
real
movie life. Is famous. I ain't gonna talk about it. That was disgusting.
What was that on?
He was famous for his fucking schlong.
That was a good movie, though. It was a good movie, though. That was a real good movie. It just shows you the inside of the business, man. That's all that movie did, man. Foul ass business. All that adultery going on.
The adultery, diseases.
Mm-hmm.
Homosexuality.
Hell yeah. You see the Jews in New York City, they passed a law about they got to take some type of class or some shit. Because they, you know, about the Jews spreading herpes, sucking them babies.
Yeah, I heard that on the radio today.
Yeah. There's a law they got to take some kind of class or some shit.
I was
man.
Reading that because, because Mayor de Blasio, he said that he was negotiating with them fake Jews.
Yeah, right.
Because people was. Because the so-called Jew, they have a circumcision. I'll just say for the camera, in case. Sir, I can't speak. In case people ain't heard of this before. Yeah, they got a circumcision ritual. The Jew, when they have a baby boy, they circumcise the baby, and then a rabbi, what they call a mole, he sucks the blood out the baby's penis with his mouth.
Oh my God.
All right, so.
Oh my
So
goodness.
Now the state of New York is trying to pass laws. But they're not going to prevent it, though, because now they said that they're negotiating with them to work something out. Like he said, now they got prevention classes.
Right.
But because the reason they do it is because little babies was catching herpes. Some of them caught AIDS.
Some of them died from that shit.
Yeah, some of them died from
sure the fuck did.
Little devil babies.
Yep.
But I heard of one rabbi, he was playing damage control, and he's like, I've done 35,000 rituals, and I haven't spread any herpes.
Oh, my goodness.
So he admitted to sucking 35,000 baby penises. I seen that shit. I posted it on Twitter, bro. 35,000 baby, he sucked 35,000 baby penises.
And they got the nerve to say they are the chosen people?
Where in the scriptures, show me the scripture in the Bible. Where it says to suck a baby's penis. Could you put it? I can assure you it doesn't exist.
Anybody in their right fucking mind ain't gonna do that shit.
35,000.
Whew.
What the? He just enjoys it.
There's only
365 days in a year. I mean, he's doing three or four a day.
Yeah, he's more than that. Yeah, he getting busy. He's getting busy. That's some foul shit, man. And then some of them was like, motherfucker, y'all ain't testing me if I got herpes. Told them motherfuckers kiss their ass, man.
Because when a baby grows up anyway, and they get him up inside the Jewish bathhouses, they just going to rape him. And the so-called Jew rapes his own sons. Man. You know what I'm saying?
That was a Jew. That Asian girl. You see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a Jake.
Man, all these hoes look good, don't
they? Yeah.
I tell Ohio State University ain't no joke. There's some hoes for your ass up there.
Hoes.
And hoes. I didn't say women. I said hoes.
Hoes.
These bitches are whores.
Hoes.
That's another reason why America got to be destroyed. We got all these beautiful women. Because a woman's supposed to be something that's supposed to be pure.
Oh, man. Delicate.
Yeah, something delicate, pure, clean.
Feminine.
But they done turn these women, they done trick these hoes out, man.
Oh, yeah. Turned them the fuck out.
So that's why we just look at them like they just pieces of meat. We don't look at them like, it depends on the woman, too, you know what I mean?
Delicate vessel.
Yeah.
You can't stink, man.
And you can't treat most of these women with any kind of respect.
Mm-hmm.
every once in a while, we may meet a cool hoe.
Yeah, cool.
We can kick her, you know, talk to her. But that's very few and far between.
Yeah.
I'll go bring that out.
Yeah.
So, Rock, 10 and 7, or 8. Because of unrighteous dealings and injuries and riches got by deceit.
Esau.
Riches got by deceit.
The kingdom is translated from one people to another.
Bad scripture. Beautiful scripture.
America got all of his riches by deceit.
Hoes.
What's up with y'all hoes?
What's up, hoes? Yeah, so his country got all of his riches by deceit. They said hi to us. I don't know what to say.
What's up, hoes?
They don't say hi, you know what I'm saying?
Got by the seat. So they have you believing they built this America up.
Oh, shit. She dropped her.
You see that?
She dropped her purse.
She deserved to get hit.
Her purse is in the middle of the road.
I'll laugh too.
Look at them Edomites got you thinking that they built this motherfucker kingdom up. God damn, man. What the fuck?
Don't tie that.
You get busy, some nasty come by with tight shit on.
That's why he's talking about hoes. They walk wearing tight ass pants.
You see that?
We can see their pussy lips and everything. You know what I'm saying? They hoes.
Hoes.
No, we like hoes.
Hoes?
I mean, Indians right there.
See, even the heathen women come over here. Over in that homeland, they wear dresses. You know what I'm saying? They come to America, they start wearing goddamn tight ass pants. Just saying, that's why a lot of them Muslim bitches come to America.
Yeah.
Because it gives them the chance to finally be a hoe. She's like, I can never be a hoe back in Saudi Arabia. Now I'm finally free.
Finally free. My head off. I ain't getting stoned to death.
Yeah, because they stone your ass to death. They don't play that shit
in
Saudi Arabia.
You see the video ISIS stoning them motherfuckers?
Hey, that's
them bitches.
They doing good work.
That was a bad video, man. They were stoning like 6 women at one time, man.
There's adultery, commit adultery.
Something, I don't know. But they're stoning shit out. One of them got hit, man, and she just slowly fell. Got hit again while she was falling. God damn, man. And them rocks was coming. They was coming, man. Hell yeah.
Even though adulterous asshole, I mean, a bitch can repent. You know, but it's unlikely to actually even ask for repentance.
Right. America is like all these women that want to be free. The women just want to be free.
Yeah, because these women, they ain't looking for repentance. They don't even feel bad about committing adultery.
You know what I'm saying?
So they deserve the pile of stones. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because people will be like, oh, y'all talking about killing bitches. Killing women.
Bitches.
We ain't kill nobody. I never stoned nobody.
That was wrong.
So actually, no, we just putting the word out there. We ain't killing nobody. The ISIS motherfuckers, they take this, they kill your ass.
They probably going to try and kill us.
Shit, they
believe that's coming. They gonna,
that shit's set up anyway.
We're public enemy number one.
ISIS is set up by the Mossad. That's why ISIS ain't attacked Israel. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know ISIS is set up by the United States government. And a Mossad. That's why they never attacked
him. Hey, what's up? Come here.
What's up, baby?
You nappy-headed hoes.
Yes.
Don Imus hoes.
Did say Don Imus?
That's it.
She had a little fro.
She thought you was talking to
her. Oh, I was talking to her. I asked her if they knew ISIS. They don't probably know who the fuck ISIS is.
They don't have a clue, man.
They thought you was talking about that shit right there.
Ice. Yeah, they thought I was talking about some ice.
Yeah. I'll let you know if Jane's still.
You're all stupid. But I'm a woman, though. I expected that from them, though.
Yeah, women, though.
But these men the same way, though.
They got a clue, man. They totally lost. They just totally lost.
Look at this motherfucker.
This motherfucker got shorts.
Goddamn shorts.
He got shorts on.
He probably high on pills or something.
He probably ain't from a cold place that get cold and come here.
And he ain't ready for
he didn't bring his clothes with him.
Is this Ohio State's full of people that ain't from Ohio?
Coming up here from California and shit.
Yeah.
You ain't ready for this cold ass shit. And this ain't nothing. Just think about them brothers is over there in Chicago. Woo-wee. Fuck. I couldn't live in no goddamn Chicago. That's some cold shit right there, boy.
Yeah.
You know, they freezing their asses off teaching on the street.
What's up with you hoes?
Motherfucker, this is the frozen chosen for real.
Yeah, I went to Chicago in the winter one time.
Ooh-wee. Right off that big ass lake.
Yep.
I know Cleveland get cold as fuck too.
I got a precept to the scripture you just read.
Did you take turns with that camera? And frozen.
This is Wisdom of Solomon 5:1. Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such as have afflicted him and made no account of his labors.
Right now we in the spirit in great boldness out here on the streets.
That's right.
But soon we're going to be in his face in great boldness when the Lord gives us that power. You know what I'm saying? We're just going to take that shit. We're going to take them, take their children, and all that substance.
Everything they got. Everything. You know that's bad when the Most High going to give you a whole nation of people to put in slavery.
And the whole earth. All that gold up in Switzerland, that's all us, man.
Man, that's tons and tons and tons and tons and tons. Hell, Russia.
That's all our gold anyway they stole years ago.
I forgot how many they got, but they like in the thousands of tons of gold.
Yeah, thousands of tons.
And that's just one nation, like Germany.
Because all that gold in the banking systems, that was started by Israelites anyway. Because originally it was started by the Knights Templars during the Crusades. And that was the Israelites that set that whole thing up. So the so-called Jew, Esau, came up there and swindled all that shit. He stole all that shit, man.
Took it all. What are you supposed to do?
He's the biggest swindler on the planet Earth.
He's doing what he's supposed to do.
You got gloves this summer?
Yeah, this shit gets cold, man.
Damn,
fingers. It's like Sub-Zero just did a fatality on your ass, and your fingers are about to shatter.
Yeah, it's worse than last week because it's wind.
Yeah, wind ain't no joke.
It's worse. It's way worse.
And we're going to do shit like that, too. You play Mortal Kombat, Most High going to give us power. I'm crazy, man. I'm going to throw a magical snowball at somebody. They're going to freeze into a block of ice. It's just gonna shatter their asses, man. We're gonna rip motherfuckers' spines, spinal cord straight out of their body.
Hell yeah.
Do the Kung Lao. You remember Kung Lao? You ever play Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
I know that's before your time.
Yeah, I seen that.
Yeah, the Kung Lao fatality. He just took his hat and cut a motherfucker in half right down the middle. That's a shit.
Mortal Kombat. I ain't never played that either.
Oh, man, I was a master, boy. I know all the moves.
I used to watch people play it.
I still know the fatalities.
Look at the thighs on that. That's Thor. That's Thor's wife walking with them thighs. God, I'll smash that, man.
Nothing to do with that.
I don't know. That'd be interesting.
Mm-hmm. I'll smash that, man. I like that thick shit, man.
Then she come out. We get that bitch pregnant. That baby coming out strong as hell.
Yeah, right.
Cause some man will walk for a week after coming.
Crazy thing. Oh, let me read this off.
That Esau.
Oh shit, man. I don't know. That's Esau.
No. Ask him.
What's up, homie? How's it going?
Sir, are you an Edomite?
Yeah, the magical cave.
Yeah. That's probably a wicked ass Jake. A wicked ass old son of a bitch.
She just got blown out. That's how you see it all the time. Women walking funny right here. They just shot a porno, got their asshole blown out.
Yep. Hell, these dudes too.
Yeah, these dudes, yeah.
They walking funny like they got a butt plug in.
What's up, homie? What are you smiling at me for?
You like it?
That's good.
Homosexual?
You looking for a boyfriend?
The faggot likes you. Fucking faggot.
He heard you saying ass get blown out. He thought you was like.
He's like, oh, like, yeah, you're speaking my language.
Right. Look at that thick thing right
God
here.
God damn.
Look at that thick thing right here.
It's hard to concentrate with.
Ain't that crazy, man?
That's crazy.
That's Most High showing us we're going to have a lot of gifts when that time comes.
Damn.
Look at that. That's a great big ass, man.
What? I ain't never seen nobody big fat asses in my life.
Right.
We done seen like three in a row.
These is gifts.
I mean,
for us.
People on the gifts. Camera. Did you get him? We gotta start getting them on camera because the people don't understand.
Mm-hmm. They won't believe unless they come down here.
You I ain't never know. Seen it. Just
you won't know.
When it gets warm, they're going to drop 20, 30 pounds.
Yeah, you're right, too. Because
that's most high, like in the kingdom, we're going to have whatever we want, man. Because sometimes you be in a mood for a skinny bitch. Sometimes you just want that big, thick bitch you can't even explain.
Variety.
Yeah, you got a variety. Yeah. We like a variety. It's like you just don't eat fried chicken every day.
Hell no.
You know what I'm saying? You got to switch it up. You know what I'm saying?
You want some salmon?
Yeah.
You know?
Have some spinach, some mashed potatoes, some macaroni and cheese. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
You got all the different flavors, man.
Like a box of chocolates. You never know.
Right.
That's why people, too, man, they try to hate on you. Well, they can't talk shit about this camp. We already got crackers in this camp, so this is the cracker camp.
Right.
Esau's camp.
This is the Esau's camp. But you don't see people will hate on you if you get with a white woman. And they must be gay, man. You know what I'm saying? I like all types of women. I ain't just gonna live. First of all, real like Big Guy said, when Big Guy was in the camp, he said, I can't be picky. I like the women that like me.
Right.
He's like, that's the women I like is the ones that like me. For some brothers, it's hard to get pussy. You know what I'm saying? It ain't easy. So you gotta take what you can get. If all you can get is a nice little white girl, that's what you get.
That's
what the Most High gave
you. She's nice to you, man. But you know.
If you like her, you can kick it with her.
You know what I'm saying?
And a bitch ain't gotta believe in the truth at all either. Because none of them really believe anyway. So, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't even matter, man. Because that's really what you call a cock blocker. That's a faggot shit. When you tell a brother, oh, you can't get with her because she's a white woman. She's an East Indian. That's, you know what I'm saying? That's evil. What's up? Y'all know America's going to be destroyed by the Most High?
What the fuck is that?
That's that heathen shit. Ricky Tiki Tink shit. But that's that shit, man. Then you got people that'll cause adultery too. Cause you'll come in the truth and they'll say that you can't get a woman unless she believes in the truth. You gotta leave her. And that's madness too. Cause you ain't ever supposed to leave a woman once you have sex with her. Mm-hmm.
You know, motherfuckers just saying that cause they want her.
Right, they want it. You gotta leave her, so yeah, so I can get her.
That's a wicked nigga, bro.
Cause, yeah, you know what I'm saying? We might call bitches hoes and shit. But if we get with a so-called good woman, you know what I'm saying? We're going to do our best not to kick the bitch to the curb, you know what I'm saying? You just ain't just supposed to fuck them and leave them.
Where did you end in that Isaiah 60?
It's prior round.
Because I'm going right back to that.
14. Yeah, 14.
Okay, I'm going back in that because that's nice, man.
Yeah, that 60 is nice. That's all talking about the kingdom. Talking about putting these heathens in slavery. Put them in servitude.
That's right. You stopped at 14, you said?
Okay. Yeah.
I'm going to start back at 15. Shit.
It's slavery, man. Slavery ain't no joke. It's gonna be a good time for us.
You know that scripture when it said it going?
I got one more thing to say.
You know that scripture when they said it going?
So, how y'all doing? What language they speaking?
So, you know that the scripture where they said they're gonna bow down to us and lick the dust off our feet? No, to my, I don't know what's that.
Yeah, that's in Isaiah also. I could find that. One of my brain cells rub together real quick.
These mittens help.
You just look, your hands froze.
Yeah, they froze.
Yeah, I got something. I got icicles in my beard.
ISIS is in your beard.
I'm like Jack Frost. You know, yeah, ISIS. ISIS. I got ISIS in my beard. What about your boy, the lead singer from Creed? You know about your boy, lead singer from Creed? He said the Illuminati's trying to kill him. He said the core of ISIS was in his family.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
But you can tell they really setting that fool up, bro. Because his wife done turned on his ass. She calling the cops, telling everybody he's crazy. And they said it. He said they emptied his bank accounts out and everything.
Damn. Wow.
That dude's a superstar.
I didn't read it, though. I saw it. But
I just watched his videos on YouTube.
Right. Some bad shit, man, dealing with this one. Some bad shit.
Revelation. Ah, shit. What the fuck? Damn it. Bible's falling apart. Revelation 2 and 2 and 25. I'm 26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power to the nations. That's red letters. So what does that mean? So what does it mean to have power over the nations? That's because the Lord came for the nation of Israel. We're all Israelites out here. I ain't no Edomite. You know what I'm saying? I'm an Israelite. He's an Israelite. He's an Israelite. All of our brothers in this truth, we all Israelites.
That's right.
By the seed, we from the seed of Jacob, okay?
You are daddy's side.
From our father's side. We are, you know what I'm saying, we're physically Israelites, and that makes us spiritual Israelites. Because there's no such thing as a spiritual Israelite. Because you got people to say, oh, we grafted in the Gentiles.
Yeah, right, yeah.
They don't understand that grafted in. Because we have Israel, our brothers are scattered amongst the four corners of the earth. I was watching that. I'll be watching that your boy Pastor Dow sometimes. I be getting so mad I just want to break my computer screen.
Ooh.
You ever watch that fool?
Yeah, man.
Motherfucker, here it is. He said, I know I'm an Israelite. But then he got white dudes, so-called white dudes, up in his congregation, right? And he's sitting there calling them Japhets.
Yeah, he confused.
But what it is really wickedness. Because what if some of them so-called white dudes up in his congregation is actually Israelites?
It'd be Jake, sure.
But he's telling them they heathens.
Yeah.
And in the back of his mind, he's better than them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Because
the scriptures say the first shall be last and the last shall be first. That dude's wicked and evil, man. I be wanting to curse your boy Pastor Dal out. Can't stand him. What's up, homie?
Man?
Let me read this. Revelation.
Warming up,
I seen the GMS was getting on the apostles. They was getting on Pastor Dal. He's trying to say the white man wasn't Esau. Dude's bugged out of his goddamn mind. And he always got videos of him playing the guitar.
Oh,
boy got no skills.
Lord,
I mean, he's like 50 years old or something. He's got the skills of a third year player. You know what I'm saying? The spirit is not with him. I'm trying to get some fame. Got advertisements on all of his videos. Oh, shit. It was the most high saying he wasn't pleased with Pastor Dow. Putting a smack down on him. They get so cold I can't hold the sign. But yeah, you gotta watch people to get, if they got YouTube videos teaching the Bible, if they got ads on their videos, that means they're the devil. You supposed to deactivate your advertisements. You ain't gonna make no money off of ads nowhere.
Activate them.
Yeah, you have to activate them. Right, exactly. And anybody teaching the Bible, you ain't gonna get no ad revenue. You gotta have millions of hits, or at least every video gotta have like 50,000, 100,000 to get any kind of money. So you got people out there who they think they gonna be superstars and shit. You know what I'm saying? Wolves in sheep's clothing. Revelation 2 and 26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. Keeping his works means teaching his word. You know what I'm saying? This is that work. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. As the vessels of a potter, they shall be broken to shivers.
That's what you're going to do with that rod of iron. Crack them upside the goddamn head.
Even as I received of my father, and I will give him the morning star. Oh, yeah, the morning star. You know, during the Byzantine Empire, they called the Roman emperor the morning star. Because they considered Constantinople, you know, back in that day, they considered that to be the new Jerusalem. You know what I'm saying? But they called the emperor the Morning Star. You know, that represents rulership, power, enlightenment, wisdom. Because that's, what's the Morning Star? They called Yahawashah the Morning Star in Revelation. He's the Morning Star, the Son of David.
Yup.
How about I get that?
Let me read this. This is Isaiah 32 and 15. What's the deal? I wanted to stop at one time. Until the Spirit be poured upon us from on high, and the wilderness be a fruitful field, and the fruitful field be counted for a forest, then judgment shall dwell in the wilderness, and righteousness remaineth in the fruitful field. And the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness, quietness, and assurance forever.
Because really, the real fruitful field is Israel. You know what I'm saying? The elect of Israel.
And my people shall dwell in a peaceful habitation.
Yeah, this ain't no peaceful habitation right here. You know what I'm saying?
And in sure dwellings and in quiet resting places. All this goddamn noise, man.
Ain't nothing quiet about this shit. You can't think straight with all this goddamn noise.
Right.
It's Babylon right here.
Yep. When it shall hail.
Not only the noise, the traffic. Fuck, what about these women?
Yeah.
That's a horrible noise.
Black woman.
That's like, yeah.
You get two or three or more of them motherfuckers together, bro. It's over.
Sound like a pack of wild animals.
Yep.
This shit is scary, bro. So this shit is an abomination, man.
When it shall hail, coming down on the forest, and the city shall be low in a low place. Blessed are ye that sow beside all waters, that send forth thither a feet of the ox and of the ass, and the ass. Woe to thee that spoilest, and thou was not spoiled, and dwellest treacherously, and they dealt not treacherously with thee. When thou shall cease to spoil, thou shalt be spoiled. And when thou shalt make an end to dealt treacherously, they...
You know, Israel's treacherous too.
Oh, yeah.
Because we talk a lot of shit about the heathens.
More treacherous.
Yeah, Israel's wickedness surpasses the wickedness of a heathen.
Yep.
Because Israel's supposed to know better any goddamn way.
Shall deal treacherously with thee. O Lord, be gracious unto us. We have waited for thee. Be thou their arm every morning, our salvation also in time of trouble. At the noise of tumult, the people... Oh, that's the internet. Let me go to that 15 now. This is back to Isaiah 60 and 15. Whereas thou hast been forsaken and hated, so that no man went through thee, I will make thee an eternal excellency.
What does eternal mean?
Forever. You can't even fathom that word, man, what it actually means. You can't even fathom it.
Well, that's what they called the Lord's eternal. The eternal one.
Yep.
The Lord everlasting.
Yep.
Or God everlasting. Well, in Hebrews. Well, go ahead.
Alpha and Omega.
Oh, yeah, that too.
I will make thee an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations.
Joy of many generations.
That means we got lots of children.
Yeah, many sons.
Many sons.
That's right. You can't have sons in this wicked ass kingdom.
Sons you can enjoy.
Well, if you have children.
Oh, bring some mind that scripture I was getting out when the camera cut off last week.
What was that?
What was that? A couple weeks ago.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Keep going. This
camera did cut off on you.
Yeah,
oh shit. There goes Satan.
What's my chance to bring that out?
Yeah. That should be hard to pick up with some gloves.
Yeah.
That's why it's impossible to turn them pages with gloves. You be out in the cold, boy, you gotta take them gloves off to get them pages.
Yeah, you gotta,
use
the Bible on the
phone. Yeah, use the Bible on the phone. That's probably the smart thing to do.
Yeah. You're right, though. You're right. Because I can find some badass scriptures with my Bible, man. I can find with my the one on the phone, man, because it got that search engine. That boy is bad, man. This is a nice scripture, man. And this is what the Most High likes, man. You don't like you having kids and care less about them, don't even give a thought about them. You know what I mean? This is Ecclesiastes 25 and 7.
Well, that's because most of us are. That's why most fathers, they're fucking dicks, man. They're just assholes. Their children are like, like a nuisance to them. You know what I'm saying?
They're a huge burden.
Like, I can't wait to see my sons.
You know?
Well, yeah. That makes the happiest thing on earth.
Yeah. Can't even enjoy see your my kids. Son. You can't enjoy
but why I can't even enjoy them?
You can't enjoy
I got to share time with that baby's mama.
Mm-hmm.
This is the adulterous ass hoe. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Yeah, with shared custody. What kind of bullshit is that?
They looking at us in envy like they mad as hell.
Yeah, it's police.
You see them?
Staring at the police.
They staring at us for? Here we go. There be nine things which I have judged in my heart to be happy, and the tenth I will utter with my tongue. A man that hath joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy.
Yeah, because we live to see the fall of our enemy. We pray to the Most High that we can live long enough. Just live just long enough to see the fall of our enemy, to see Esau be destroyed, to see America be destroyed, consumed by fire. That's what we pray for, that man. To see these wicked ass Israelites get destroyed.
I pray
I get to see the day I get to see my baby's mama get fucked up.
Yeah, pray to be a part of that destruction. Yeah. You know, pray for that power.
Hey, put that camera on that bus. I pray that you get right from out of the sky. That's just like your one boy, that old man in the gospel. He prayed that he could live long enough just to see the son of God be born.
Man, they down up this.
Yeah, the police is every goddamn one. Right there must have happened. They driving fast as hell with no sirens.
Yeah, they're going after something.
Fucking cops think they can do whatever the fuck they want.
Hey, there's another one.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them. You know. Somebody probably got caught littering or something, so they gotta call out the whole squad.
God,
I just drop a glove.
Oh no, I dropped something. I'm
hallucinating. Alright, I'm good. Yeah, but you, like we was talking about your children. I wanna say something. You got most of these faggots out here, they don't even care about their kids. But if you do care about your kids, your baby's mama will take them. You'll go to court, these wicked ass courts, and the judges will take your children away. Ain't nothing you can do about it. And then you get a bitch pregnant, then a bitch could just kill your baby. There's nothing you can do about it. Here it is, that's your semen, that's your seed up inside of her. She laid down with you willingly, and she gets to choose whether your son lives or dies. What kind of wickedness is that, man?
That's right.
That's why this shit's got to be destroyed.
With no punishment.
With no punishment, she'll get rewarded. She'll be like, you made the right choice, baby. And her mother will talk her into getting an abortion. You see that all the time. A young 16-year-old girl get pregnant, and then her parents will make them get an abortion.
It's crazy.
And then you got these fucking faggots out here, they'll get a woman pregnant, and then they'll pay the woman to get an abortion. How stupid is that? That's like murdering yourself. That's like committing suicide.
Right.
Fucking stupid people, man.
Thou shalt also milk of the Gentiles, and shalt suck the breasts of kings, and thou shalt know that I, the Lord, am thy Savior and thy Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob.
The Mighty One of Jacob.
For brass?
Yeah, that's what Yahweh Shai means. The Redeemer, the Deliverer.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So-called Jesus. It means Yahweh says, the Most High says.
For brass I will bring gold, and for iron I will bring silver, and for kozozo, abundance metals. Pretty much he's saying he's going to multiply the earth, man. It's going to grow.
That's just like when King Solomon was king. You had the Queen of Sheba bringing him gold. All the heathens on the earth, they're going to pay tribute. They're going to bring us women.
Lots of their daughters.
You see that dumb bitch?
You know she's freezing. We're going to have women in a... Women's going to be like a commodity. You know what I'm saying? You make a deal with somebody, but like, look, I'll give you five women... you know, for that big ass barn of wheat you got back there. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Or whatever.
Yeah, we're gonna be having, you know, gatherings.
Well, for the heathen women, you can't sell Israelite women.
Right, we're gonna have gatherings. You know, like niggas have cookouts now. We're gonna be getting together then, and we're gonna bring gifts to each other. It's gonna be women.
Yeah, bring each other
nations,
gifts.
Women of other nations. Bringing nice gifts, man.
We can't get nobody gifts now. We ain't got nothing to give.
We ain't got shit to give, right. For wood, brass, and for stones, iron. I will also make thy officers peace and thy exactors righteousness. Violence shall no more be heard in thy land.
Oh, violence. So this proves that the so-called Jews living in Israel right now, they're not the real Israelites. Because it said once we get in the kingdom, they claimed that they just came back to the promised land, right?
Yep.
The Lord had gathered them back together. But how come they got so much violence over there?
Right.
You got the whole, goddamn Gaza is a pile of rubble. They over there murdering people.
They said Gaza hasn't rebuilt at all since they got bombed.
They can't rebuild. They that's like the poorest people on earth.
There's still massive fighting going on over there in Gaza Strip.
Hey, you got Hezbollah. They said they get ready for war.
Hamas.
Hamas,
yep. They're getting busy.
That's why they constantly, because, you know, they funded by Iran. And that's why Israel is steadily trying to get the United States to go into Iran.
Yep.
And you know when they go into Iran, it's a wrap. Because that's coming, bro.
That's right there.
The United States is going to go to war with Iran, Russia, China. That's what you call World War III. That's already started, actually.
And get his ass handed to him.
Oh, you see, you see that parade they had in Russia? They was holding that missile. And that missile in Russia, that said, Obama, this missile's for you. To be delivered personally to Obama or something.
Yeah. Y'all got something in my pocket.
So they want to shoot missiles on America. They going to shoot missiles. And there's a news in the paper, too. I said the paper. You got newspapers?
Same shit.
Yeah. There's a story. I was at my dad's house. He had an actual newspaper. It shrunk. It was like small now.
You don't ever read it either.
I read it. It had some decent stories in it.
Columbus Dispatch.
Yeah, Dispatch ain't bad.
Yeah, it's a little compact now.
That'd be good if you was a paper boy now.
Yeah.
I'm right back. I was a paper boy. That shit was heavy as fuck.
Even the Monday's paper.
Shit, they ain't
yeah.
the smallest one of
the
them
Sunday,
all.
You got Sunday
paid by
break
commission,
your
though, didn't you?
Yeah,
nobody ordered no papers.
Nobody ever. Every time I go on my paper route to collect, nobody wanted to pay me.
Come back in 2 days.
They might come back tomorrow. I ain't got it on me
right now.
But some people, they hook you up, they give you tips and shit.
Yep.
But they done did away with that now. And that was like the best job for a young person. You can't even get it. You gotta have a driver's license now. You gotta have proof of insurance. What kind of bullshit is that? They got me off track, man. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, I seen a story in the news today that said China has now got more submarines than America.
Yeah.
America's trying to say they're not as us. They're not as sophisticated as America's submarine. But you know, that's damage control. That's a lie.
Right. That's to make the people feel good.
That's wishful thinking.
Right. Damn, baby.
So why do you think China got all these submarines? Just because they like swimming and they just like the ocean?
Right.
What the fuck you think they gonna do with them submarines?
Yeah, them motherfuckers are ICBM capable.
Yeah, those submarines have one purpose, and that's war. Missiles, torpedoes.
Right, they're not delivering food no more.
And they got submarines that they call aircraft carrier killers.
Damn.
Have you seen that? They got the supersonic torpedoes
mm-hmm.
that can to take out an aircraft carrier. They hit that aircraft carrier in the sweet spot. It's a wrap.
One shot.
All them F-35s and all them fighters is going right into the goddamn bottom of the ocean.
Damn right. How many aircraft carriers America got? Like 20 of them? It's close. It's up there, though.
Aircraft, they do got like 20.
Yeah, it's a lot of aircraft carriers.
I don't know
carriers.
If they use them all, but it's ridiculous how many they got.
I believe they use them all. You're right. They use them, a lot of them. Because they got military bases on almost 1,000 countries now.
Yeah.
It's almost a thousand, it's a million, what you call them, U.S. embassies and shit?
Yeah, the embassies.
Yeah. That's over a thousand, damn near a thousand countries.
Yeah, because America put all their money into those aircraft carriers.
Mm-hmm.
And it's funny how Russia ain't got but one.
Just one.
They don't even, they put their money in ICBMs.
Yep. And they hardly use that one. Hardly ever use it. It went right through the English Channel the other day, man. They was in a panic.
And Russia's too, they got them fighter jets that, I heard those F-35s are garbage. That new plane, American, you know the F-35.
The new one, yeah, they say they wasted billions of dollars.
Yeah, wasted billions and billions of dollars. They're garbage.
Yep, they said it can't even shoot right.
They can't even fly right. They got all kind of problems.
Yeah. They said they're going to use them anyway, though.
They say Russia's new fighters, they got some advanced form of stealth on them, bro. They got some plasma stealth. That's why Russia got the most advanced technology on Earth.
You see, if Russia just deployed their new that new radar system they have, that the stealth planes that they got, that the Americans use, ain't stealth no more. They're useless. There ain't no such thing as that stealth no more. Because they use those new radars they deployed, man, that shit picks up every goddamn thing. They made those stealth planes obsolete. China has it too. Those new radar bands shoot different types of bands out there, man. They see all kind of shit.
That's why the Russian fighter jet did a flyby on a United States destroyer in the Black Sea, hit it with an EMP or something, shut down all of its electrical system.
Took that shit out. And that's one thing that the Ukrainian army keeps mentioning, is that Russia keep hitting them with sophisticated electronic shit.
That's why Russia shot that nuke off in Ukraine. And they said it shut down the electrical systems for like down. I don't know how many hundreds
shut
of miles
down.
Radius.
Shut shit down.
That shit's gonna be real, man.
Russia wants to use that shit, man. They wanna use it too.
They need to hurry the fuck up. I'm sorry, I'm being patient. What's up, homie?
He found a piece of pussy. Ain't no woman dealing with you. Found you a boyfriend, huh? Fucking faggot. Heathen bitch.
Cocksucker. Yo, Esau.
The heathen bitch.
That's a Sephardic Esau.
I hate that motherfucker.
I hate him too, man. He got a foul spirit on him.
I hate that motherfucker.
He's a Sephardic Jew. I heard Alex Jones, he's like, oh, the Sephardic Jews, those are the real Jews. That motherfucker ain't no Israelite. He's a fool. His wife must be Sephardic or something. He can't piss that bitch off. He won't get no pussy.
I don't know.
But he be fucking Leanne McAdoo. Because she got Alex Spirit on her. You can tell he been fucking that bitch.
I don't think he fucking nobody. I think he's a fag.
I heard people do say, did you hear that shit?
I personally think he's a fag.
What's that Girardi dude? They had his one. I heard stories of
fucking Joe Biggs.
Not y'all. He probably a big faggot too. But what's that one? Anthony Girardi. Not Girardi. Is that his name? That Girardi. That weird.
I know what you're talking about.
Somebody, there's a story on the internet. I forget what channel. But they said that he took him out on a night on the town over there in Austin. And he took him to a transvestite club.
Oh,
and he's like,
oh, I remember that.
Yeah,
I remember
so
that.
So this dude, he in the trainees and shit.
Yeah. They all fags, man. God damn.
And your boy Alex Jones is always saying, he always talking about how wicked and decadent he is. So he pretty much admitted he's doing some weird shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a fucking freak.
He hanging out with all them Hollywood movie stars and shit.
He got that look on him. He's a freak.
Doing some
something wrong with him.
Doing
man.
Some weird shit, boy.
Something ain't right about Alex. Fucking Alex Jones. Bill Hicks.
Oh, Bill Hicks.
Fucking weirdos down here. Not just big booties. They're weirdos down here.
Yeah, there's some weirdos. We live in Weirdo Central, man.
That's why John Travolta's coming here making his movie.
Oh, John Travolta's a weirdo.
Yeah, he's a fucking open fag.
He sacrificed his son.
They're all right.
Yeah, Illuminati.
And then right now they're looking for 500 extras to play in the movie.
Shit, I ain't being in your movie.
You have to be a big fag when you have to go audition for that shit.
I wonder where they going to shoot.
Right.
You know John Travolta ain't gonna talk to us. He gonna see us. Yeah, he gonna call his bodyguard.
Cuss the fuck out. Fucking freak with all that goddamn makeup on and shit.
Yeah, wearing facelifts and
it's
makeup.
Crazy, man. A man, grown ass man, walking around with fucking makeup on.
That's why I give you
Freak Nation.
Back to your boy Robert De Niro. They said he always refused to wear makeup in movies.
Why?
They
going after him for some reason.
Yeah, they going after him. Especially Robert De Niro made that movie The Good Shepherd. They could have possibly liked that movie.
The Good Shepherd?
That movie, Good Shepherd, showed you the origins of the Skull and Bones. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it showed you in that movie, if you want to be successful in America, then you got to wrestle butt naked with other dudes, let dudes piss on you. You know what I'm saying? Do all kind of faggot shit. That's how you become successful out here.
That's right.
And he showed you that in that movie.
That's right.
That's one of the best movies ever made. And the average person watched that movie got no clue what's happening. They have no idea. That was a good movie.
Yeah, great acting.
But they had no idea what even happened in that movie. They had no idea it was about Skull and Bones. They had no idea it was about the CIA. You know what I'm saying? They had no clue. Because, you know, the Bush family, they's from Skull and Bones in Yale University.
All of them down.
And George Bush Sr., he was the director of the CIA up in his early years. And then you had a Bush in the White House for ever since 1980. Because under the Reagan administration, Bush Sr. was the vice president. Then he became president. And then his good friends in the Clinton family, because he said the Clintons were like his brothers. And the Clintons ruled for, they ruled,
you know,
they're like Caesars.
That,
yeah, they were, then the Clintons ruled for 8 years, and then the Bushes came back. And now we got Jeb Bush president again.
And he will be president if he do wrong.
And Jeb Bush is saying, oh, I'm not like my family, yeah. I'm my own man.
Yeah, he's supposed to be different.
And then they got another Bush in the wings after him waiting to come
up.
They got a whole family of a line of Bushes, just like Caesars, just in the wings waiting to rule over you fools.
I'm hoping we don't go to goddamn Florida, man.
No, me neither. Well, I'm just saying, man. You got another goddamn Bush, and he's getting a major push. Mm-hmm. I didn't mean to rhyme. You got another Bush, and they asked, this dude's like the top goddamn candidate.
Top.
A goddamn Bush.
Yeah.
You can't be serious.
That's right.
This shit, you can't make this shit up. We're gonna ravish these hoes when the Lord gives us that power. I'm gonna get it, bro. I'm gonna get the scripture. People gonna say, you got people to watch the videos like, oh, y'all wrong.
Man, we're gonna get busy, man. With all the ones we have, we're gonna be cruel to them and everything, man.
And what if somebody asks you, they be like, well, what scripture says you can have more than one woman?
Shit, Isaiah.
I was about to get it. I'm gonna show you what scripture says. Isaiah is a prophet, right? Isaiah, he's the same prophet.
Well, they reject him just like they reject Paul.
Well, Isaiah prophesied the Son of the Most High. He prophesied about Yahushua.
That's right.
Okay? And everybody loves to talk about, oh, Isaiah. That's all the prophecies of the Lord is in Isaiah. Okay, let's read this. Isaiah 4:1. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel.
That's right.
Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. So what does it mean for a woman to be called by your name?
That's
like,
right.
When you marry a woman, she takes your last name, right?
Yeah.
She takes your name.
Yeah.
So this means you're going to have multiple wives.
That's right.
Even though if you hardcore in the truth on this side in this kingdom, you shouldn't be trying to have a lot of different women.
Time for that shit.
It ain't time for that shit. But I'm not going to judge
really
you if you do.
It really is, right. You know, but it really isn't, man. You ain't got no time. Just wait for it. It'll come.
Because some brothers just attract women.
Yeah.
They got so many, they got to beat them off with a stick. Like, you know how my grandma said?
Oh, I ain't been like that in years, bro.
That's what my grandma...
I was literally that way, man. I never approached bitches like, what's up, baby, with a rap and shit. I was waiting. Bitches came to me in bars and clubs, man.
That's what my grandma always said, that he got so many women, he got to beat them off with a stick. I'm like, I wish I did.
Right.
Shit.
You never have enough, though, man. You think you had about 20 bitches, man? You still want more. You still want more, man.
That's good. Yeah, that's just part of being a man.
Yeah, we're going to be cruel to these hoes when we get them, too. Even they're going to be coming with truck carloads of shit, food, water, because times going to get bad, man. They're going to come with their own shit, baby. Look, this is my gift to you. This is my gift to you, honey. I see you a man of the Lord. I see you following the Lord. I see you fear the Most High. Here, baby.
Well, right now, that's how these women should be on this side.
Yeah, yeah.
If a woman talking about, oh, I believe in the Most High.
Instead of being, what you call the word, instead of being,
they should be trying to,
treasonous.
Right.
Treasonous
they
bitches.
They should be taking care of us.
That's right. But these bitches, that's why they gonna get killed. Because they some treasonous hoes.
They should be giving us money and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Literally, man.
They should be giving us a place to live.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
If one of you women watching this video talking about you believe, well, let me move in with you. You know what I'm saying? That you believe in the Lord so much. Give me a place to stay.
Yeah, yeah, babe. We keep each other warm.
Give me some new clothes. I don't need no good shit. Just buy me some. Just give me my
babe,
daily bread.
We can go to thrift store together.
Yeah, we go to the thrift store together. Now, we go thrifting.
Hell yeah.
We go thrifting. I love the thrift store.
I love it. I love the thrift store.
Bro, I go to the thrift store. You never catch me in a mall. I go straight to the thrift store.
Hell yeah.
We notice the thrift store got better shit.
Man, this is weird, man, because yesterday, man, me and the bitch was in the mall, man, and this expensive pea coat that I wanted, man, she's like, try it on, I'm going to get it for you. I was like, nah, winter's almost over with. I don't want that shit, man. I don't want that shit right now, man. Hell no. And I didn't. It was nice, too. I always wanted that type of pea coat, too, man.
What is it?
A pea coat. You never seen a pea coat? Them black coats, they wore.
Oh, yeah?
They look, you know, you used to see them eat them like roots.
Oh, okay. I know what you're talking about.
Nice-ass black pea coat.
Yeah, the big-ass buttons.
Yeah. She's going to get it for me yesterday. I'm good. Because winter is almost over with.
Yeah.
I don't need that goddamn thing. I'm just going to have the bitch buy me something else. That's, you know.
That's something about these brothers, too. Y'all got to be smart. You living in Satan's kingdom.
Yeah.
You don't get a little bit of money. You can't be blowing that shit on top dollar shit.
Useless. Yeah. Shit you don't need.
You go take your ass to the thrift store. You need some electronics. Go to the pawn shop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Straight to the pawn shop.
Right.
Go to the, you know what I'm saying? Go to flea markets, swap meets. Matter of fact, too, because you don't want to get all these big corporations your money anyway.
Damn.
You want to go help out a little guy. The little dude that ain't got shit, he gonna hook you up with a good deal at the flea market. You know what I'm saying?
For real.
He gonna hook you up, bro.
That's a spot.
I set up sometimes. Funny. I go down to the flea market, set up a booth. You know what I'm saying? Put a table out up at the. And we should do some videos. We should go do some videos this summer at the flea market south end.
Right, I can't wait.
That's like out in the wilderness,
I've been
bro.
Waiting for that one.
Have you been out there?
I haven't been out there yet.
Bro, that's like going out when the Israelites was out in the wilderness. Yeah. You go out there, it's all hot and shit. It's like a desert. The sun beating on you.
The drive-in.
I'll be out there kicking truth to brothers out there,
drive-in
man.
Drive-in movie theater.
Yeah, the drive-in movie theater. That's the ground spot. Is gravel. The motherfucking
nothing but Jakes out there.
Nothing but Jakes.
Nothing but Jakes.
You know what I'm saying? No, it's pretty much nothing but Jakes, bro.
Yeah, that's something we need to do too, man, because that'll just show that Israel everywhere, man.
Hey, we should go out. It's a good time out. Lord willing.
It'll be warm soon. It's gonna be warm soon.
I mean, if we still here by then, because shit, I might you don't know what's gonna happen.
Right. The way shit heating up, man.
Day to day, hour to hour. You take it minute by minute, second by second. Yeah, but if we out here, if we still here in the goddamn summertime, we should go out there, bro.
That's a big if.
We made that one video at the flea market.
The West Side.
The Mexican flea market. It got deleted, though.
Wait a minute.
That pissed the Mexicans off, bro.
Yeah, that's the tribe of Israel. Yeah, the tribe of Israel.
Oh, yeah, the Northern Kingdom?
The Northern Kingdom.
Yeah,
right.
That's Issachar.
Yeah, that was just Issachar.
Oh, yeah,
there's a lot of them.
Yeah, it is a lot of them.
That was different tribes.
Yeah.
That was different tribes. I could tell by their spirit.
Yeah, Northern Kingdom.
Yeah, Northern Kingdom. I could tell by their spirit. It wasn't just Issachar. It was a lot of them.
Yeah, because the Northern Kingdom was massive. It was huge.
Yeah. Beautiful-ass women, man. Beautiful-ass women.
The mamacitas.
For real, man. We got to go back out there with the private camera, though.
Oh, spy camera.
Right? Yeah. The spy camera.
I got some outdated technology now.
Right.
I got to get some new shit. I still got an old-ass spy camera. Terrible picture. Look at that, man.
We don't like getting trapped.
Wear some goddamn poor man. See, these bitches, they want to be hoes so much, they got to wear some tight-ass pants. Man, I was just thinking about that flea market in the summertime warming me up, bro, out here in this cold.
I can't wait, man.
But when you go out there, motherfuckers be looking destitute, though. And then you got Jakes out there at the flea market. See, that's why I hate Israel, man. They always trying to backstab each other and swindle each other. Everybody trying to rip each other off, being cutthroats. That's another thing about them flea markets. Because you'll have a lot of, not everybody's like that. But a lot of motherfuckers, yeah, they just trying to swindle you, man. Trying to sell you some broken shit that don't work. That's Jake for you, man.
Used car salesman.
Yeah, used car salesman. soon as you buy that shit, you drive down the street, that shit falls apart like the Blues Brothers car.
It ain't shit you can do.
Ain't shit you can do about it. Shit just falls, shit just breaks down, man.
Right.
Cause that's what Jake means too, because Jake means supplanter.
Don't even want to acknowledge a brother walk when he walk by. Don't even want to acknowledge brother.
Oh, damn.
You know, big thighs. You don't even want to acknowledge a brother, man. Like, what's up, man? Motherfucker don't even want to speak to you and shit.
Fuck these motherfuckers, man.
No good motherfuckers. Just looking to fuck Jake over, looking to fuck a brother over.
That's why I hate Israel, man.
Fuck these motherfuckers.
I fuck 2/3. That's why we all care about the elected Israel,
that's
man.
That's it.
We don't care about none of these other fools.
Hell no. And it's our pleasure to come out here and curse these motherfuckers out.
See, I got a scripture to back it up. Because people say, oh, you got to love everybody.
No, the fuck we don't.
You got to love everybody. You got to pray for them.
These motherfuckers, that's what they looking for you to do, is give them a blessing or some shit and pray for them, man. They going through hard times. Like this bitch was on tag. She going through her sickness. She's sick and her and one of her kids is sick. But this bitch is on her page
asking
showing her
prayers.
Ass with some provocative shit
yeah,
on.
Yeah, asking for prayers.
Yeah, right, man. Adulterous ass, nasty ass hoe. Talking about the Lord is good and he looking over you and
I hate bitches like
this. Look over me because I'm sick and
those,
my child.
Those be the nastiest of all the hoes.
The nastiest of all of them.
All the hoes, bro. I be on the internet. I be seeing some foul shit.
Pussy smelling like fucking shit.
I got it.
I seen this one bitch. She was like, she said that she looking for somebody to hook up with. She's like, oh, by the way, I live with my baby's dad. And we got kids together, but we're not together no more. But it's just a friendship thing now. He don't mind. Like, what the fuck? You bitches need to put it there.
Yeah, he trifling just like she trifling. Cause he probably still hitting it.
Right.
Knowing that she's fucking other niggas.
That's nasty.
That's nasty.
And then she's trying to.
That's nasty.
But you got some dudes like, oh, really? It's like, I'm good. I'm cool with that.
She ain't gonna have no problem with me coming over, is he?
Yeah, and they'll come over and play PlayStation with him.
Hey, man, check this out, cause it happened to me. I met this motherfucking ginger, man. The bitch was bad. A ginger. She was a ginger. Thick, curvy. You know the way I like them. Out up in Hilliard, man. I met her out at a restaurant. I met her at a bar and shit. Hit it off. She digging them. Of course she digging me, my arrogant ass. And we went to her friend's house, kissing, rubbing on each other, this and that. Then she came out with it, man. She's like, come on home with me. You know, went to her crib. Right when we started to go inside, she's like, I forgot to tell you, you know, I live with my husband. And it's been like this for like 5 years. He don't, you know, we're not sleeping together. You know, he sleeps on his side of the house. I'm on my other side.
That's
on my
worthy
side
of
the
death,
house.
Man.
Man, I didn't go in that house, man. And I ain't deal with the bitch no more after
hell
that either.
Hell no.
The
bitch need put to death for that.
Hell yeah, man.
Cause, I mean, yeah, that's worthy of death.
I don't know to try to convince me, talking about, yeah, my last boyfriend, he lived here for 2 years with me. Oh, adulterous motherfucking hoe.
That's why I told you I was messing with this one girl.
That's
when you gotta watch out for a girl who always just wanna come to your house. And you, she, I'm like, how come I can't just go to your house?
Yeah, right. Cause she got something
like,
to hide.
Oh, we can't do that.
Cause she got something to hide.
Like, I wanna go to your house.
Oh, but you know, most niggas don't care. Don't care. You got a husband at home? Oh, this come to my crib. That's
right. I wanna go to
that's
her right. house, you know, some right. Raider refrigerator.
Damn right. You know, just to be somewhere different.
Yeah, be somewhere kicking somewhere
you know,
different.
Just, you know, for real, man.
It's like, I wanna kick it at your house, baby. She's like, no, we gotta go to your house.
Bitches is hoes, man. But a wicked ass motherfucking man. A wicked ass man don't give a shit.
Cause you got people to look to commit adultery. I got a scripture
shit.
I wanted to bring out. That's why we hate these people, man.
Shit.
We ain't gotta love everybody. The Lord don't love everybody.
Man, you got your nut leaking out this bitch and the motherfucker still fucking her, eating her pussy and every goddamn thing.
Cause all these people, that's what you call a cream pie. That's disgusting.
That's some foul shit, man. That's some foul shit, man.
Got 4 minutes.
The main bitches that's doing that shit, the ones that's acting like they're not.
Yeah, cause
you know what I mean? That one bitch that's so supposed to be so righteous and so pure, that's the main bitch you look out for. Shit. nasty. Fuck these bitches. Fucking nasty ass.
Let me get rid of this real quick. Matthew 12 and 48. But actually 47. Then one said unto him, behold, thy mother and thy brethren stand without, desiring to speak with thee. But he answered and said unto him that told him, who is my mother and who are my brethren? And he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brethren.
Family.
For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother.
That's right. That's
so that's our only brothers.
That's right.
If you ain't doing the will of the Father, you're not our brother.
That's right.
We, you know what I'm saying? We don't pray for you. We pray that you die.
Right,
you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
We, if you're an adulterer, we pray that you catch AIDS and drop dead.
And that brings to mind, man, a wicked ass nigga. This is how wicked ass niggas they talk. He's always calling you family.
Yeah, what's
who's
up,
that?
Fam?
Who's that? Who's that?
What's up, family?
Sarnetta.
Oh, that's family. So, yeah, we don't talk like that.
Right.
What's
like
up,
Tito.
Fam?
Tito always said, I love you. That nigga rob your ass.
You gotta watch, man. You gotta watch out for another man saying he loves you.
Yep.
Because love is an action, not a word.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Family. What's up, family? Family.
That's
family.
That's like my two family. Sons. If my sons, if I told them I loved them or something like that, they'd say I was gay. You know, that's some gay shit. You don't tell another man
that
you love.
That sounds kind of corny, though.
He's like, I love you.
I'm feeling your sons there, boy.
Yeah, they,
I'm feeling them there.
We was over at their grandpa, my dad's house.
Right.
I said, go give your grandpa a hug and a kiss. They said, that's gay. So you got to watch out for, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit.
They don't play that shit.
I never told my dad I loved him.
Right, you don't have to tell him.
Right.
There's some things you just know.
Yeah, you just,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, like I said, love is an action. Love is a four letter, like your boy Eddie Griffin said in that Master P movie. He said, love is a four letter word, just like shit and fuck.
Right. There you go.
What movie is that with Master P? Some comedy? Foolish or something like that? You remember that shit?
I can't remember.
You remember them bootlegged ass Master
yeah,
P movies?
Yeah, I remember. I saw all that shit.
Man, y'all, I got the hookup.
Repo.
All that shit's on motherfucking Netflix.
Make you say,
is it on Netflix?
Yeah.
Oh, he was watching Master P movies.
Yeah, I watched them all. I don't know why.
I mean, that last dime was terrible. That shit was horrible.
Got 1 minute.
Oh, shit is 1 minute, bro.
Oh shit.
Fucking got hypothermia.
Yeah, really? I got goddamn, hypothermia, frostbites. That's where, yeah, we like Jack Frost. You know, Jack come from the word Jacob. We frosty
jackass.
Out here. Jackass. Yeah, really? That's where, yeah, jackass? Jack. A jackass. Hey, Jacob is a jackass. Two thirds are jackasses.
Steve-O, Jan Beard.
Steve-O?
They're from Jackass.
Oh, Jackass. Oh, yeah, the TV show Jackass. Most of them dudes is Jake's, though.
Johnny Knoxville.
Let me read this Jackass. Real quick. This is 1 John 3 and 18. My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth.
Oh, that was on time. That was on time. So, yeah, we're just going to end it on that. All praises. Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders, apostles, GMS. Right. We out of here. Peace. Hit the record button.
We out here frozen to death, man.
I just put whatever.